Awam. Let's give all praises to Yahweh, Ba'ashim, Yahweh Shai. Double honors to our apostles and elders of GMS. And much love to you, Akim, across the four corners, pushing this word in sincerity and in truth. It's the brother Za'ab with the brother
Kashkwal.
And we're here with another quick lesson dealing with procrastination and being slothful, pretty much, you know, which kind of goes hand in hand. You know, when right now we're at a time where you got to keep your hand to the plow. Okay, we're at the end of this thing, man. And there's a lot going on to prove that. Okay, so we're just going to jump right into it, Kashakwala.
If you don't mind, can you pull up on the Edema Online the definition of procrastination? Okay. Because that word procrastination, it could mean like to hold off from day to day, or to deter or delay. And ultimately, you know, the times that we're in now, you don't want to put things off because you don't know, you know, the next move you will be making. You know what I'm saying? If you want to link up with a brother, make it as expedient as you can. You know what I'm saying? If the spirit jumps on you to do a lesson, press that record button. You know, be quick to do something. Or, you know, push the word or whatnot.
Yeah, Karen. This is procrastination on etymology.com. And this is, it means a putting off from day to day.
See, exactly. A putting off from day to day. Mm-hmm. So you say, I don't feel like doing it today, I'll do it tomorrow. You know?
Okay.
You know that saying, every day is not promised. You know what I'm saying? And that's a true statement. So if you have the time or you have the ability to do it at a certain time, then just do it. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
Just do it.
Kind of, especially if you're just putting it off for vain things, you know, things that doesn't really matter in this time, you know, just to go and probably play video games or just go hang out, you know. And it's not saying there's anything wrong with doing that, but you know, we're in a work first mentality. That's what you gotta be in. That's why the brother said, hey man, sometimes you may be in traffic, you know, you a video comes to your head, you know, if you do have the ability to, you know, you probably do it in transit. If not, at least make a note on your phone of that, so that, you know, it keeps in your mind, because you should be constantly meditating on the scriptures, constantly meditating on the things that are happening. I'll read on a little bit more. This, it means put off till tomorrow, defer or delay.
And with that, James 4 and 13. James 4 and 13, because that goes exactly into what that definition is describing. Right, putting off from day to day. All
right. This is James 4 and 13. It says, wherefore, gird up the loins of your mind, be sober, and hope to the end for the grace.
James.
Salakia.
Damn. Yeah. Come.
I mean, Peter. Salakia. The spirit went all the way to Peter. Salakia. This is James 4 and 13. Go to now, ye that say today or tomorrow.
So go to now, ye that say today or tomorrow. So go do it now. The person was like, I'll do it tomorrow. Keep reading.
Kind. We will go into such a city and continue there a year and buy and sell and get gain. Whereas ye know not what shall be on the morrow.
There you go. You don't know what's going to happen the next day. You know, the spirit can all, you know, have altered something or made you, you know, go a different way. Your plans that you have planned maybe not go the way that you wanted them to. So just do it that moment when you have the chance. Keep reading.
Kind. It says, this is 4 and 14. It says, it is even... For what is your life? It is even a vapor that appeareth for a little time and then vanisheth away.
Come. So what is your life? And, you know, it appear for a little time and then vanisheth away. You know what I'm saying? So make sure you make it, like the brother Tazan Warren says, be punctual with things, you know? This work is pivotal, you know? It should be the first thing that's on your mind in the first place. You know, so if you have the opportunity to do something, do it. You know, Yahweh Shai gave his life. Why can't you give 5 minutes, 5 to 10 minutes to do a quick video? Why can't you give 15 to 20 minutes to do a video with a brother?
Kind. I got a quick precept. This is Proverbs 27:1. Boast not thyself of tomorrow, for thou knowest not what a day may bring forth.
There you go. Boast not
of tomorrow,
because you don't know what the next day is going to bring. You know, you don't know what's going to happen the next day. You know what I'm saying? If you want to expound on anything, brother.
No. That's fine. That's pretty straightforward. You know, this is a pretty straightforward message, man. Mm-hmm. You know, just do what you got to do. You know, at the end of the day, you know, you really should be, you know, the apostle Salakia Taha was, you know, made a video. If you're not, you know, if you're not passionate about this, then keep it moving. Mm-hmm. And at the time that we're in, you gotta be on fire, man, because everything is vexation of spirit in Babylon. Everything. You know, from just the food that we eat, the air that we breathe, the way we gotta deal with people every day, the traffic, a woman. Okay, disease, afflictions, all these things, you know, is vexation. So these things are supposed to automatically always spark different thoughts in your mind about the scriptures.
Exactly.
Okay.
You should always constantly be meditating, and like it tells you to meditate in the book of Psalms, the first chapter, second verse, Sirach 39:1, Sirach 6:37, all those meditating type scriptures, it always should be on your mind. Since you're in Proverbs, man, you can go ahead and go to chapter 6, verse 6.
You want 6 and 6?
Yeah, come on. Because this will, it's pretty much telling you, man, get off your lazy ass. You know what I'm saying?
Come on. It's Proverbs 6:6. It says, go to the ant, thou sluggard.
It said, go to the ant, thou sluggard. It said, go to the ant, meaning see its ways. Because the ant is always working. Mm-hmm. And so it's putting in work. When do you see an ant just laying up, resting? He's putting in work, so his buddy next to him and his other buddy next to him is good, and he'll be good himself, and he can keep the colony growing. You can continue on that.
It says, consider her ways and be wise.
It said, consider her ways and be wise. Consider meaning to perceive or to look at, you know? So look at the way of the ant, you know what I'm saying? Being wise, we all know what wise means, having a wise mind, being prudent, you know, because it's a wise thing to look how the ant operates. That's how you should be operating in the truth. Work first mentality.
It tells you that in Job, you know, look at the beasts and they will teach you, because they know certain things, you know. Mm-hmm. And these animals out here, man, they have a certain level of spirituality that we have lost, you know, that we're trying to regain. They're still in tune with their ecosystems. They know when rain is coming, they know when storms are coming, they know when tsunamis are coming, they know how to move, they pay attention to the signs, okay? Most people today, man, they don't know what's going on, you know, for the most part. So it's pivotal. That's why the scripture here is saying, look at the ant, look at what it's doing. Mm-hmm. It's always in a workmanlike preparing for tomorrow rather than putting off for tomorrow. It's constantly preparing for tomorrow. That's like we are. We're constantly putting in this work so that when Yahweh Shai comes back, we can give an account of what we've been doing. You know, we can show that, hey man, this is what I've been doing. I've been, you know, working, I've been trying to please you. Okay, not putting off.
Like it tells you in the book of Revelation, I think the 21st, or if I'm not mistaken, but 22nd chapter, you know, he's coming back to judge you off your works, you know? Mm-hmm. So, you know, like, if you're gonna work, don't put it off. If you gotta work a 9-to-5, you gotta be there Monday through Friday, you're not gonna miss Monday and say, I'll make it up Tuesday or work on Saturday or something. No, you go to work on Monday, you get your work done on Monday. You make it a point to be on work on time. It's the same thing with this truth. It should be the first thing you do, man. It should be the first thing you do.
Kind. So we read on?
You can stop there.
I think that's the point right there. You had something else?
No, I think that's about it.
Color? Nah, I had pretty much Salakia. Yeah, because you know this is a hot topic, man. We're in a time now where things are so serious. You don't have time really to be playing around. You don't have time just to be putting off, you know, because it's becoming quite evident that the Most High is angry with this place, and he's coming back soon.
Okay.
You know, with all these things that are happening, man, you got to be out of your mind to think, you know, it's okay just to be sitting down, fooling around, you know, for the most part. You can't do that.
Yeah, scriptures, loosely paraphrasing, it tells you not to use your liberty to satisfy the lust. That's just something that Paul was talking about. Man. This liberty, or, you know, aka grace period, is a time to reevaluate yourself, reevaluate your whole life, turn back to Yahweh Hashem Yahushai, and get right with them before all hell breaks loose, man. Because if you don't have the Spirit of the Lord with you, man, in that day, hey, you SOL, as they say in the world, man. Shit out of luck, you know?
Yeah, kind.
So make sure, you know, this is something that you shouldn't put off from day to day. It's something that should be every day.
Exactly. This is, again, Ecclesiastes 10, and I start at 18. And it says, by much slothfulness, the building decayeth, and through idleness of the hands, the house droppeth through.
Because in the Apocrypha, in the book of Sirach, it talks about, you know, idle time can, you know, paraphrasing, you know, much idle time can produce wickedness, man. And it says, if you have a servant, put him to work. And we're servants to Yahweh Hashem Yahushai.
That's right.
So we can't be sluggards. We can't be slothful in our work. A half-assed job will get you a half-assed reward.
Kind, yeah. So you gotta constantly, you know, stay in this, man. Constantly do something, you know. Either you're with Akim, you know, dealing with spiritual things, or you're doing a video. You might be reading, okay. You're watching a video, you know, or watching the apostles, the elders. Right now, on a daily basis, they're a minimum of at least 2 to 3 live streams throughout Israel. You know, pay attention to these things, man. You know, sometimes you may not be able to do a video. You may be at work. Put your headphones in, you know. Listen, you know, or listen to the Bible. You know, just try to always constantly, you know, and there are going to be times where you're going to have, you know, you could listen to regular music or watch a movie or do things. But always keep in mind, you know, like the brother said, you know, this is the first thing on your mind. And after that, we can, you know, you can get some time. It's just like with school. You go to school, you line up, you go to class, and then the bell rings, then you have recess. You don't go to school and it's recess, and then it's class. You know, there's an order in the way things are done, okay? So, unless you have something else, brother, you know, with that, bro, we just want to make sure, you know, that we edify. This was edifying to brothers out there. You know, stay on point. Don't put off for tomorrow what you can do today. Okay, and with that, we just give all praises to Yahweh, Bashem, Yahushai. Much love to you, Akim, across the four corners, and double honors to Apostle and Elders of GMS. Shalom.
Shalom.